Hey guys, Dr. Hans here from Optimal Wellness, and today I want to talk about tennis elbow, or also known as lateral epicondylitis. So when you have tennis elbow, you're going to experience pain on the outside of your elbow, and that pain can go down all the way into your wrist. And it can cause a lot of swelling, it can cause inflammation, and it can cause reduced range of motion in the elbow joint. You also might notice when it becomes severe enough, you start to lose grip strength as well. So when it comes to lateral epicondylitis or tennis elbow, the good thing or the good news is that it doesn't usually require surgery. And as long as you stay committed to resolving it through natural ways, you can get really good results. So there's three tips or three solutions I have for you today to deal with your tennis elbow. The first thing you want to do is something called the RICE method, which is rest, ice, compress, and elevate. So the first thing you want to do is rest it from those activities or those things that you know that's causing or exacerbating the condition. So when it comes to tennis elbow, it's usually a result of a repetitive injury. So it could be from, you know, tennis, those racket sports. It could be from weightlifting, using a hammer, anything where you're doing a lot of repetition with the elbow and wrist. And that can cause micro tears in the tendons and in the soft tissue, which is going to cause that inflammation. So you want to avoid those activities, and then after the first, you know, between the first 24 to 48 hours, you want to make sure you're icing it. The ice is going to reduce that inflammation and swelling, and you want to keep that ice on there for about 15 to 20 minutes, and then you can take it off for an hour, and then you can repeat that. The second thing you want to do is you want to compress the area. So you can use a brace, you can use a wrap to keep that compressed. That's going to help reduce swelling in the elbow. And then if you can put your arm up, kind of on an armrest, that's going to help reduce the swelling as well, or elevate it. And then the second thing you want to do is you want to exercise the joint, which kind of might sound kind of counterintuitive, since moving that joint can be kind of painful, but we want to make sure we keep motion in there so we reduce that stiffness in the joint. So the first thing you want to do is just start by stretching it. So there are a couple things you can do to stretch that. The first thing is called an eccentric wrist stretch. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab a small weight, or, you know, a can of soup or anything you have in your house that weighs about 2 to 5 pounds, and you're going to place your arm over the side of the table and let your wrist stretch or fall down. So you should feel a stretch in the muscles that run over the top of your forearm, and then you're going to lift it, and you're going to do 3 sets of 10 of this. Okay. The next thing is we're going to stretch these extensor muscles here and these tendons. So you're going to take your opposite hand and you're going to slowly push down on your fingers, and you're going to feel that stretch through your forearm. And you're going to hold that for 30 seconds. And then I want you to do that 3 times. Okay? And then the last thing you're going to do is you're going to start strengthening your grip strength. And you can use a tennis ball. Tennis balls work great. I've got a back peanut that has 2 rubber balls on it. But what you're going to do is slowly squeeze and release. And you're going to start by just squeezing for 3 seconds and let go. And you're going to work up to squeezing for 10 seconds. Okay. And then the third thing that we do in our office is called Graston technique. So that's a soft tissue technique that we use to break up adhesions or scar tissue. So we have 6 different instruments we can use. So for the forearm, this is one of the ones we like to use. But we can use that over the forearm to break up adhesions and scar tissue that form. And what it's going to feel like to me as I do this is we're going to look for those kind of grittier, kind of bumpy areas in the arm where that scar tissue is. And then using this, we're breaking that up and allowing those tissues to move correctly again. So the first thing we do is we kind of scan over the forearm, looking for those restrictions, and then we can use more targeted tools once we find those restrictions to get in there and really, really work those areas. So when we do this, it takes about 5 minutes, 5 minutes for the treatment on the elbow itself. So I hope this information helps you with your tennis elbow, and if you found it useful, make sure you like and share this with others. And then if you have additional questions, make sure you go over to our Facebook page or our website at mywichitachiro.com and check out the other things that we treat as well. Thanks, guys.